This is my friend Jake. He owns a vintage card shop, but has always wanted to make a video game. Understandably, running your own business takes a lot of time, so he just never gets around to it. But making games has never been easier. Jake just needs a little incentive. Thankfully, he's very competitive.
Hey, I'm Jake, and I've spent 4 days learning how to make games.
Hey, I'm Aya, and I've been making games for 4 years.
Do we really have to spin a wheel?
Yeah, dude, we have to let fate decide.
How am I supposed to make all this art for a first-person shooter?
Okay, so I thought this might come up, so last week I reached out to Unity and they agreed to give me 2 codes to their student plan, so we have some 3D models that we can use just for this project. Good luck!
Okay, I don't know the right ways to do this or not, but I think I just want to start with a simple environment and then we'll work from there. I like how this fence looks. I'm just going to try to make like a starting area here. It's a simple backdrop. Let's see the clouds. Okay. Oh, and it even brightened it up.
I found these water pistols that I'm going to use in my game. My grandma told me that I was never allowed to develop a shoot 'em up game, so hopefully this is a workaround for that. Instead of having targets or enemies, I thought it would be fun if I tried to make this multiplayer using Unity's netcode for game objects. 4 days isn't a lot of time to do that, but I think I can do it.
This lollipop here actually kind of looks like a target. Maybe it could spin like this whenever I shoot it. I mean, that might be a little too advanced for me, but right now I kind of like that.
Okay, so after planning yesterday, I got the character movement up and running. I know it looks a little weird in the scene view to just see arms, but that's how these work. I started working on the multiplayer network stuff. There's a lobby system now, so players can connect to each other.
Let me drag this holy ice cream cone. I think I'm going to use all these sweets and I'm going to make a game called Sugar Shooter, where we eliminate all the sweets. I want a big building on this corner, but the color's not matching up. I really wanted a park here on the corner. Okay, that actually looks really cool.
I added some camera cuts to when the player dies. It's nothing fancy, but I felt like it added some needed weight to that moment. I know we're just using water pistols, but I'm not sure what the alternative of shooting someone with a water gun would be.
Dude, everything is pink. I just made this.
Yesterday, I got multiplayer working, but that won't be fun if we're just playing on a flat plane. So today, I'm going to focus on making a level.
Render pipeline converter. There it is. And then initialize and convert. Bang, baby, let's go.
I've been playtesting the map a little bit. There are some tight areas, but I think generally it's okay. I did notice that because of the way that I made movement, you can do these super high jumps off of stairs.
Okay, so I have a prop weapon. I'm going to put it in camera view. Okay, so the weapon has a good location. I can't look up and down, but that's all right.
The player currently has infinite shots of their water gun, and that's just going to turn the game into who can aim better. I had the idea to include health and ammo pickups. I'm hoping that that will encourage more dynamic gameplay.
So this is one of the guns from the FPS creator kit from Unity. I don't know how I'm going to get a bullet to come out of this thing.
Footstep sounds are actually really important in an FPS game so that you can hear where your opponents are. I'm already synchronizing the multiplayer animation, so I thought it would be smart to tie the footstep sounds into that. So in the actual animation, I'm calling a footstep event, and that plays a sound that is synchronized for all of the online players.
I'm going to see if it shoots. Dude, why am I floating? And I have 999 errors.
Competition doesn't really matter if no one is keeping score, so I added a scoreboard. It displays each time you die or can be toggled with a key.
I'm gonna have to start from scratch.
Earlier, I ran some quick tests with my friends, Tom and Hedgebite, and we found a bunch of bugs.
Okay, this is what I was Unity learning about, so let's just start all over. I'll play the game and see what I can learn from this. I wonder if I could use this. I'm deleting everything around this.
Shooting downed opponents currently counts as kills, so we have to fix that.
And I should be able to use the script from these monsters to put on my donuts and all my sweets. Let me bring Sugar Town down into this party.
Players with low frames per second can jump multiple times before the game ever registers that they've left the ground. It results in them floating like this, which we definitely need to fix.
Please shoot. Yes! And if anybody asks, that blue stuff is Listerine. And I should just be able to use the target script and put the monster script on my suites.
Yes.
If you spam the reload button while you're shooting, you just get infinite bullets. So we're going to need to fix that too.
Time to hide some sweets. Oh, that's a cheeky one. Now we're good.
Hey, buddy, how'd it go?
I'm actually pretty proud with how it turned out. You want to try it?
Before we get into that, thank you to Unity for sponsoring this video. Making games can feel overwhelming, but Unity provides a free engine, hundreds of free courses, and a student plan that gives you free assets and discounts. It's never been easier to make games. Most of the 3D models Jake and I use in our games are included in the student bundle. Dude, what was your favorite model?
The police car was really cool. There was an ambulance I didn't really get to use, but I really liked that one too.
The cool thing about the assets provided through the student plan are that they help you stay focused on learning how to make games. It can be overwhelming when you're learning to also have to make art. So you can start with some simple free assets, and if you enjoy making games, you can upgrade to more thematic assets later by purchasing them in the Unity Asset Store. Bonus, because with the student plan, you also get a 20% discount on all of the assets there. If you're a college or high school student, you can apply today to get access to the student plan. To make it easy, there is a link down in the description. Welcome to Sugar Shooter. Eliminate all the sweets. Okay, so we got ice cream. We got what do you call this? A liquor?
Okay, nobody calls it a liquor.
I do think it's a little offensive that there's also a donut up here next to a police officer. So I'm just going to point that out. Okay, the donut at the police. See a theme? Wait, why is this donut? Is that me or is it?
It's a little squashed. I wanted it to be like the O for police. That's clever. Come on, dude.
Have you ever been to like a frat party and the floor is sticky? It sounds like that.
It's Sugar Town, brother. Everything is kind of sweet and sticky. This is next level lore here. So that person to your left kind of parked like my grandma.
Wait, hit this person?
Ice cream over. Yeah, not in the lines.
Holy, you didn't blur their license plates, dude?
Oh, no.
Come on.
Okay, look them up. What do you want me to do?
Yeah, but where are they at? This place is empty.
Yeah, he went for a walk.
Can you go in any of the buildings? That'd be sick.
I had how many days to do this?
Okay. This is super impressive. For 4 days? Super impressive. Ooh. I'm Spider-Man!
Who are you?
My name is Jeff.
Dude, see? This sounds... It makes sense now.
Wait, what? Does Spider-Man sound like that? I found it.
Jeez.
Oh, yeah, a little jingle?
367 seconds. Nice, man.
Yeah, a speed run. Are you ready to try my game?
Yeah, let's do it.
Do you have any friends?
Oh, yeah.
What? Get wrecked, dude. Get squirted on, nerd.
Oh, my. Get heady. Who was that? I want to know. Oh, no. Sorry. Dude, I'm sorry.
No!
Oh, spit.
There is team killing, just so you know.
Who killed me?
Bando has negative one.
From where?
Who was that over there?
Who was that? Was that you, Sam?
From where?
Man. Oh, I think that's me. Up top left.
Oh, no.
No, I'm out.
Later,
no
loser.
Way.
No, I ran out of it. Click.
Oh my.
Where?
I'm in the
Stop! Are you clicking at me that quick?
Behind you. Oh, 2-piece nugget meal. Let's go, baby. Oh, about a 3-piece. Oh yeah. Oh, the kid's getting hot. I need help. I need ammo. Who was that? Oh, 2-piece and biscuit.
Gee, three more.
Behind you.
Oh my gosh!
Oh my!
I had no ammo.
Hey, come on, Aya, one more. You good for it? Oh, well, you killed me!
Yeah, I wanted the last kill. Game, set, match. Let's go, baby! Yes!
We did it. Good games.
So, how do you guys think we did? Let us know in the comments. If you're interested in the more technical details of how I set up my game, I made a public post that is linked in the description. If you've ever wanted to make a game, why not take advantage of the free perks offered in the student plan linked in the description. To the current and Patreon YouTube members, thank you for directly supporting my ability to keep creating content and making games. You're the 007 to my Boris.